বলতে চে মনে হয় বলতে তো বুদায় না হৃদয় কতটা তোমায় ভালোবাসি চলতে গিয়ে মনে
the way to Kulakan Sar for this masjid alone. This masjid is the Masjid Ubadeya in Bukit Chandan in Kulakan Sar. It's the Royal Mosque of Perek. It's absolutely amazing. The work or the idea for the masjid actually was began in 1911 when the 28th Sultan of Perek, Sultan Idris Murshidul Azam Shah, fell ill in Port Dickinson. He'd promised himself that should he recover, he'll build a mosque. And true to his word, in September 1913, the work began for the construction of this masjid. He instructed the then Colonel Huxley of the Public Works Department of Kuala Lumpur to begin the construction. Colonel Huxley appointed the architects, English architect Arthur Benson Hubbock. Arthur Benson Hubbock was a government architect who was also responsible for the railway station at both Ipoh and Kuala Lumpur. I mean, those of you guys who've already seen the Kuala Lumpur video will have noticed just how amazing his architect is. I mean, for an Englishman, a non-Muslim, to create Islamic architect of that grandeur and that splendor, It's incredible, you know. All salute to his intelligence and his research and his architectural brilliance. He, along with a state engineer of Perek, Mr. Caulfield, developed the blueprint for this masjid, and the construction of the masjid began. But sadly, the construction had to be halted for a short while because the imported marble that came from Italy was damaged between a fight between two elephants, that of the Sultan Idris himself and that of Raja Cholan. So the fight between the two elephants had damaged the marble and few of the building materials, which slowed down the progress. But eventually in 1917, 4 years later, this building was created, the masjid was created. The masjid cost at about 189,000 Malayan dollar, which roughly equates to about 37,000 British pound. You know, it doesn't sound a lot now, but during 1917, that was an astronomical figure. That just shows just how grateful Sultan Idris was to the, you know, Allah Almighty, and for recovering from his illness. Next to the masjid is the mausoleum, a royal mausoleum. And sadly for the Sultan, a year before the masjid was created or masjid was completed, you know, in 1916, he had passed away. So he never got to see the masjid being complete. And he's buried in the royal mausoleum, which is known as the Museum de Raja Al Ghufran. I think I've got that wrong, but you know, that's what the Malayan word is for the mausoleum. The front of the masjid is the Madrasa Idris Madrasa, which obviously teaches Islamic education to Muslim, you know, boys and girls. And to the right of the masjid is the Galleria Sultan Azlan Shah Gallery, which houses all artwork and prestigious events. And further to the right is the Kulakan Sar railway station. To the left of the masjid is more aspect of the city center, which is where we're going to head off now. So first of all, I'll show you guys what the inside of the masjid looks like and show you the mausoleum, and then hopefully we'll go more further into the city itself.
See you.
তোমার হবে আজ তোমার নামে উড়ো চিঠি পাঠিয়ে দিলাম পড়ে নিও তুমি মিলিয়ে নিও খুব যতনে তা লিখেছিলাম ঘের ঘামে আজ তোমার নামে উড়ো চিঠি পাঠিয়ে দিলাম পড়ে নিও তুমি মিলিয়ে নিও খুব যতনে তা লিখেছিলাম ও চাই পেতে মনে হয় বলতে তবু দেয় না হৃদয় কতটা তোমায় ভালোবাসি
Makam di Raja Al Ghufran, which is the royal mausoleum of Perek. This is where obviously all royal members of the family are buried. It's next to the Ubadiyya Masjid, which is just literally beside it. The Sultan Idris Shah himself was buried here in 1916. Sadly, there's no one to ask as to where his grave is, but as you can see there are plenty of affluent and influential, once influential people, all six were under. That's life. Doesn't matter how rich you are, how poor you are, that's our final destination. It's a bit of a morbid message, but it's the truth, unfortunately. So the actual architecture of the place, the mausoleum, is a lot like the Taj Mahal in that there's a Moorish design to this whole complex itself. It is big, but obviously it's a graveyard, so you know, it's not the nicest place to be. But yeah, it gives you time just to contemplate and just you know, obviously just think about your own contribution to life, because one day we too will be here, not as beautiful as this, maybe something more simple, but either way, six foot under. But anyway, this is the mausoleum. Let's go and check out something a bit more cheerful than this, and a bit more less serious, I guess. But yeah, thanks for watching.